Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's video, I have a great Outlook video on the calendar. We're going to cover 7 items. We're going to cover appointments versus all-day events versus meeting requests versus making those recurring. And then we'll also take a look at adding and removing people, canceling the series versus canceling an occurrence. And then I'm going to give you some tips also. So let's go ahead and dive in right now. I have the Outlook calendar already open and I happen to be on week view. So if you right click, there's 4 of the items I'm going to discuss right now: appointments, all day events versus meeting requests. And then if you notice, items 4, 5, and 6 all have the word recurring in them. Start off with an appointment. An appointment is only for you and no one else. So this could be a doctor's appointment. This could be prep time before you go and train or do something. Only for you. So I'm going to do an appointment real quick, but I'm going to make it recurring. And this is one I have in real life. And then I'll give you an example of the second one you should have. When I get to work in the morning, the first thing I like to do, check my emails, look at my calendar, and plan out my day. But I don't want to do it one day. I want to do it every day. So this is going to be a new recurring appointment. I'm going to put in that it's from, I'm making this time up, 8 o'clock. I have my Outlook set. So instead of doing 30 minutes, it does 25. So I got that 5 minute between appointments and meetings. If I wanted to make it 30, you could. That's under File, Options, Calendar. Weekly, there's daily though, there's monthly, there's yearly. I'm going to keep it weekly. It is going to happen every week, and it happens on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Those are my work days. It's going to start today, or I'm sorry, tomorrow, June 13th. Today's the 12th. And you could have this never end, but I'm going to end it just to test this. After 15 occurrences, so since it's happening every day of the week, this should go for 3 weeks just to show you how this works. Click OK. It wants a title. I'm going to check my emails and prep for the day. Save and close. There you go. Starting on Monday the 13th, that is week 1. That's 5 events. Another 5, and the 3rd week right here, ending on Friday, July 1. And that's it. Perfect. Go back to today. Recurring appointment. Here's a tip for you. I'm making this up. On the 15th, I have a doctor's appointment. So I'm going to do a new appointment. That's only me. You'd put in the doctor. You could even put in what type of doctor you're going to see. Up here in the top, here's the tip. If you're sharing your calendar with other people and they can see not only if you're free or busy, but they can see the details, I encourage you to make that private. So I don't need anyone knowing what doctor I'm going to see or even if I'm going to the doctor. Save and close, and there is my doctor's appointment, but notice it's got a lock on it, only for me, no one else. I'm not going to do it, but hopefully you see where I'm headed with this appointment and recurring appointment. Also like to put in my lunch every day because I like to take my lunch. So that'd be a new recurring appointment. I'm going to stop right here. Same steps, daily, put in some lunch time. And there you go. I'm just going to cancel out of this one though. Another tip for you before I move on to meeting request. Let's say as an example that my email and prep, act like this is the lunch that I put in. Well, I can't always go to lunch from 12:30 to 1:30 on every day. If you need to move one of these recurring appointments, just click, drag, and drop. Not a problem right there. Perfect. So that would take care of your lunch getting moved. Meeting request. This is probably the biggest one. I'm going to schedule a meeting at 11 o'clock. So that is going to be a new meeting request. Put in the title of the meeting. I'm going to just put in budget meeting for now. I'm going to invite Christian, and I'm also going to invite Carol. Again, set up the time. Send. Before I hit send, If you need to make it recurring, you could from right here. So you don't have to cancel out of here if you say, oh, I wish I would have made this recurring. So this would be a one-time meeting request, and you can put in whether it's Team or Zoom. I'm gonna do Teams. If you're in person, you would not click on Teams or Zoom. Go ahead and cover it here. I'm gonna just go ahead and make this recurring, make recurring. It's almost the same screen I had with my appointment right here. 11 to 11:25. This is gonna be weekly. We're gonna meet on Mondays, and I'm gonna end this one after 5 occurrences. I really only wanna meet 4 times, by the way, so you'll see why I'm headed to the number 5 right here. Click OK, send it off. There is that recurring meeting right there. It even has this little icon again for recurring. Meeting 1 is on the 13th, the 20th is the 2nd, 27th is the 3rd. Here you go, that's the 4th one, 5th one, and that's it. I only really want to meet 4 times. I happen to know that this is a holiday. Right click, and there is your cancel meeting. And since it's recurring, you can either cancel the entire series, but I just want to cancel the occurrence. Send cancellation. Now, there is meeting number 4. Back 2 weeks, 3rd meeting, 2nd meeting, 1st meeting, right there. There's your appointment versus a meeting request. An appointment is just you, a meeting request is other people, and then it's up to you about the recurrence. Another tip for you here. I'm gonna go right to new recurring meeting. I get this question all the time. We need to meet on the 2nd Thursday of the month and also the 4th Thursday of the month. How do you handle that? Well, you go make it monthly, and you don't want to put in the 14th of the month, the 2nd Thursday, and this is where people get stuck. They want to know, well, I need to also meet on the 4th Thursday. I also need to meet on the 4th Thursday of the month. You just make this one first, and then you do another new recurring meeting, and you change the 2nd one to the 4th. You can't put them together. I've tried. And again, you got the same options down here. So there's a tip there. I'm not going to send this one out. An all-day event. This one's really simple also. Let me move ahead a little bit. Act like I'm out of town this week, taking holiday. Right click. This is going to be a new all-day event. So I'm out on the 18th. Holiday. It already says all-day event. Notice if I uncheck all-day event, it becomes an appointment, basically. It says it up in the top left corner. Holiday appointment, holiday event. So an event is all day. That is all. If I knew that I was out of the office on PTO, taking PTO time, I'm going to make this out of the office, by the way. Save and close, and that is the 18th. And then if I wanted to, the week after, I'm taking the full week off. So you can do all day event is truly all day, and you can decide how many days you want it to be. So I'm not going to do that next one there. But do make it out of the office if you're not available. Back to today. If you're a keyboard person, Control T will take you to today, in case you didn't know that. Last one. If you recall, I had this budget meeting right here. Open it up. And again, because earlier I canceled one of them, and that was cancel the occurrence. This time, it says this is an appointment. It's part of in a series. What are you going to do? I'm going to open up the entire series. Cool tip here. I get this asked all the time. What if you need to add somebody to here? So I've got Christian and I've got Carol. I'm going to just type in my Gmail address. This is only going to send it to the person that I add. At least it'll give me the option in just 1 second. Also, if I wanted to get rid of Carol from this meeting, it would only remove Carol. Christian's not going to get the email if I was removing Carol. The same thing is Christian and Carol, if I'm adding someone, will not get the email. So here's your send update, and here's the screen I'm talking about right here. Send update only to added or deleted attendees. Because I get this question a lot. People say, I'm not sure exactly what's going to happen. Now, if I hit send update to all attendees, now Christian and Carol would get this. But I don't want to do that. Send update only to added or deleted attendees. Microsoft Team users, I have a tip for you. In Microsoft Teams, if you're using Teams, you can go to the calendar in Teams. It is tied into your Outlook calendar. You can schedule meetings in Teams, but I encourage you just to schedule your meetings in Microsoft Outlook, because I've actually seen Teams send it to everybody anyway, even though you have it, only send it to the new people. There we go. Couple more tips and we're done. This will be really quick. I'm going to make an entire video about this, but just getting around on the calendar. I'm going to go back to home in the top left. First of all, I'm still in the calendar. I'm on home. You've got these different views here: today, next 7 days, day, week, work week, month, and all that. In case you're wondering, I'm already on week. So you can click on work week, click on week. Control Alt 1 is day one. Control Alt 2 is work week. If you look at the top, it's moving. I'll do it again. 1, Control Alt 1, Control Alt 2. Control Alt 3 will take you to week view. Control Alt 4 is month view. Control Alt 5 is schedule view. I'm going to go back to Control Alt 1. I'm looking at one day. Here's the cool trick. Easy to look at the next 7 days, but what if I want to look at the next 2 or 3 days only? I don't want to look at 7 days. That is Alt 2, not Control Alt, just Alt 2, Alt 3, Alt 4, Alt 5, Alt 6, Alt 7, Alt 8, Alt 9, Alt 0. We'll show you 10 days at one time. There you go. Make sure you change your weather up here. I'm not going to do that, but obviously add location and just type in your zip, 30068. So I said I'm not going to do it, and here I am doing it. Helps if you type in the right numbers, 30068. I'm in Marriott. It pulls up Sandy Springs, no big deal. And there is your forecast. And you can change that to Fahrenheit and Celsius again in File, Options, Calendar, Weather. You pick what you want to see. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know we covered a lot. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. Any comments, please put them down below. Thank you.